I was profoundly shocked a couple of weeks ago when the news came through from New York that David Bowie had died. Over the years, we've published many David Bowie books, and Music Sales, our parent company, also publishes song books. So I was immediately called upon to write a lengthy introduction to a new David Bowie song book, or at least a David Bowie song book that commemorates his passing. More recently, Omnibus Press published The Complete Guide to the Music of David Bowie by David Buckley. The Complete Guide to the Music of David Bowie is a complete rundown of David's albums from the early records that came out in the 60s right the way through to Black Star that came out 2 days before his death. Omnibus Press also publishes Bowie Style, which I think I'm right in saying is the only ever illustrated David Bowie book that has a picture of every single group of musicians that ever backed David on stage. Bowie Style's been out for over 20 years now and has sold a lot of copies. We also published the David Bowie Black Book, which was one of the first ever books about Bowie, which was published in its first edition in 1981, I think, and which I updated twice on two occasions in the early 80s. The reason I was chosen to update this is because during the 70s I worked for Melody Maker magazine and found myself interviewing David on a couple of occasions and also traveling with him and his band on the road in America in 1976. Furthermore, when I left Melody Maker, I went to work for RCA Records, David Bowie's record label, worldwide record label, at their London office, and I was David's PR for a couple of years. During the period when Lodger and Scary Monsters came out. This meant that I had to work with him and his management team in formulating ideas for promotion. During those 2 years, I got to know David quite well, and he came across always as the most charming of men. He was very intelligent, very well-read. He was interested in all forms of the arts, not just music. Indeed, while I was working for RCA Records, I took a party of journalists to Chicago to see David play John Merrick, the Elephant Man, in the play that, it opened in Chicago and then it moved to Broadway in New York. So I was fortunate enough to watch him on stage for three consecutive nights, playing a role in which he had to contort his body because, as you know, the Elephant Man was severely disfigured. All the time I worked for David, though, he came across as being really bright, charming chap, terribly handsome and terribly engaging, and he's the sort of bloke that when he walked into a room, the room lit up, and it's a great tragedy that he died at the age of only 69.